Discussion on WPW syndrome basics. Usually, the heart rhythm is controlled by a small pacemaker situated in the right upper chamber of the heart, known as the sinus node. The signals from the sinus node are transmitted down the upper chambers to the lower chamber through the conduction system of the heart. Wolff Parkinson White syndrome is due to an accessory atrioventricular pathway which bypasses the normal atrioventricular nodal delay. ECG manifests a short PR interval and a delta wave. They are prone for supraventricular tachycardias due to re-entry mechanisms. This means that signal passing down the abnormal pathway travels back along the normal pathway or vice versa to produce a circus movement, producing an oscillation of electrical signals within the heart. There are at least 10 different locations of the accessory pathway around the mitral and tricuspid valve annulus. Each pathway gives a different manifestation in the routine ECG. The amplitude of the delta wave in each lead helps us to identify the location of the accessory pathway. SVT in WPW syndrome can be orthodromic or antidromic. Orthodromic means the downward conduction of the signal is along the normal pathway, while the return signal is along the abnormal pathway. In antidromic, the downward signal is in the abnormal pathway and the return is by the normal pathway. The word dromic means in relation to conduction. Orthodromic tachycardia has a narrow QRS complex and is the commonest variety, accounting for 90%. The remaining 10% is antidromic and has a wide QRS because the downward conduction is through the abnormal pathway. In orthodromic tachycardia, the impulse travels down the normal AV pathway into the ventricle and back into the atrium through the accessory pathway. Vice versa occurs in antidromic tachycardia. Antidromic tachycardia is often mistaken for ventricular tachycardia due to the wide QRS complex. It may be noted that pre-excitation, delta wave, does not manifest during orthodromic tachycardia. Hence, a diagnosis of WPW syndrome cannot be made during the tachycardia. An ECG taken after termination of the tachycardia will show the delta wave, so that it is mandatory to take an ECG after termination of SVT. SVT in WPW syndrome can be terminated by carotid sinus massage, intravenous adenosine, or by intravenous verapamil. Atrial fibrillation can rarely occur in WPW syndrome and can be life-threatening due to high ventricular rates. Ventricular rate is very high because the impulses are transmitted down both normal AV pathway and the accessory pathway. Moreover, the refractory period of accessory pathway decreases with increasing rates, permitting rapid conduction. In the normal conduction system, refractory period increases with increasing rate. The ventricle may not be able to track the fast rate and go into ventricular fibrillation. Hence, atrial fibrillation in WPW syndrome requires immediate termination by cardioversion. ECG showing atrial fibrillation in WPW syndrome with fast ventricular rate. QRS is wide and irregular with varying width due to the varying degrees of pre-excitation in each beat. WPW syndrome can be treated medically with antiarrhythmic drugs like amiodarone, but the current day treatment of choice in symptomatic persons with WPW syndrome is radiofrequency catheter ablation of the accessory pathway. This is more important for pathways with lower refractory period, as they tend to conduct atrial fibrillation at very fast rates. In radiofrequency catheter ablation, small electrodes are introduced into various parts of the heart to record electrical signals from the various parts of the heart to locate the site of the abnormal pathway. Once the abnormal pathway has been located, radiofrequency energy is delivered to produce a tiny, highly localized superficial burn which destroys the abnormal pathway. This procedure is done under local anesthesia and the electrodes are introduced through the femoral and jugular veins and occasionally through femoral artery. Fluoroscopic view of electrode catheters used for radiofrequency catheter ablation.
Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.